Like I said, we saw the Kenyan shilling receiving somewhat of a boost given those news. We saw trading at around 85.10, 85.30. Talk us through what was the market reaction behind this news.
I think we haven't really seen a significant market reaction. I think the market is still digesting the news and assessing the impact of it on a long-term basis. I think for this is perhaps a show of confidence on the currency, and it's likely to result in more stability on the Kenyan shilling rather than an appreciation than a depreciation.
Well, this also comes on the back of what we have seen coming through from the central bank. The central bank have come in to soak up liquidity in terms of using repurchase agreements. Talk us through some of the effects that have helped to stabilize the shilling thus far.
Yes, I think I agree. The central bank has been quite active. I think they are keen to support stability in the shilling, and I think their policy seems to be to maintain the shilling at the current level of about 85, 84. Obviously, with the strengthening, with this extra improvement in terms of the IMF vote of confidence, that should make their job easier. And hopefully, we will then now begin to see central bank allowing interest rates to fall by perhaps slowing down on the repo repurchase agreement.
And we did have the IMF also warning against excessive spending ahead of the general elections. And we also know that we have seen somewhat of an increase in the wage bill. How will this really impact on the Treasury's objective really to control recurring expenditure that we continue to see coming through in Kenya?
Absolutely. This is the biggest challenge I think the Ministry of Finance is facing at the moment. For the first time in many years, we are seeing recurrent expenditure as a proportion of the overall budget actually increasing, which is something that we haven't seen for a number of years now. And it's definitely a concern. I think the government is keen to focus a lot of its money on development expenditure, but that will then look to slow down. I expect the government will be looking to increase taxes. Obviously not the best time to be improving taxes, mm-hmm. but clearly in the next few years, given the implementation of the new constitution, the general elections, the government is going to be a bit strapped for cash, so it's quite likely that we'll continue to see Ministry of Finance under pressure on recurrent expenditure.
A bit strapped for cash. If you look at the current account deficit, it has widened, currently sitting at around 13% of the country's GDP. How much of a risk do you see this posing on the overall macroeconomic outlook for Kenya going forward?
I think this is another critical challenge. I think the upheavals we had towards the end of last year were principally sparked off by the widening trade gap as well as the very high inflation. While the inflation is perhaps back now into tame, the widening trade gap still remains, which means on a long-term basis we will still see pressure on the shilling. It's impossible, you know, you cannot sustain the shilling on a very long-term basis using purely interest rates and support from other donors. However, I think on an encouraging sign, I think the oil discoveries are a pointer that over the long term there could be some reprieve on the trade gap, but that is still a long way away.
Indeed, and when you look at the overall macroeconomic picture of the economy, it seems to be quite a positive. You're looking at inflation falling back, sitting at 5.32 currently, and we're also sitting with favorable weather conditions. What do you make of economic growth going forward? We did see it, however, slipping back somewhat.
Yes, the first half of the year was a big disappointment on economic growth. The growth rates of just above 3%. Well below expectation, and indeed we think that on an overall basis for the full year we'll still see part of this drag coming in. However, I think the macroeconomic situation is now stabilizing, mm-hmm. the currency is stable, inflation is dropping, and our expectation is that we'll see a further drop in inflation despite the increase in oil prices that we saw earlier in the year. Interest rates, although they are rising slightly, I think we also expect that that is perhaps just a temporary phenomena, but that by year-end we should then see interest rates either reverse back or begin to stabilize at the current level. So I think although we had a bad start to the year, I expect the second half to be much better, mm-hmm. and we should see growth rates propping up to about 4-5% for the rest of the year. But on an overall basis, the year is not going to be anywhere near what had been forecast of between 4% and 5%.
We know that the central bank is due to hold its meeting in about 2 weeks' time. What are your expectations on that front? Could we perhaps see further interest rate cuts coming through there?
I expect a further cut, not a big one as the one we saw the last time. I think we'll see a much smaller cut. I think central bank is keen to send the signal on declining interest rates and put pressure on banks to drop their lending rates. So I expect to see a bit of a cut, but I think they'll be cautious not to be seen to be indecisive and going one way or the other, because I think until they're confident of the stability of the macroeconomic environment, they wouldn't want to be too drastic in terms of the rates cut.